press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students. In the last class, we were discussed regarding the concepts of chemical bonding. That includes some of the basic concepts, which includes valency, valence electrons concepts, and also the concepts of what we can call the concepts of octet rule and its limitations, followed by the definition of ionic bond also can be discussed in the last class. In today's class, we are going to have a continued session of ionic bond concept, that is ionic bond. As you know, the definition of ionic bond, the bond which is formed by the electrostatic force of attraction between the electrostatic force of attraction between two oppositely charged ions. If we consider NaCl molecule, which includes the combination of Na plus and Cl minus, because of oppositely charged ions, there is an it's a force of attraction, that is electrostatic force of attraction, which holds this oppositely charged ions together. This is called what? The ionic bond. And this bond, if we can call it as one more name, that is electrovalent bond. This ionic bond is also called as electrovalent bond. Then what is meant by this word electrovalency? Electrovalency means electrovalency means it is the number of electrons that atom can gain or lose during the formation of ionic bond or electrovalent bond. Okay, electrovalency means during the formation of ionic bond, how much number of electrons gained by the anion or how much of electrons lost by the metal atom. Okay, that is represented by electrovalency. During the formation of NaCl molecule, sodium, it used to lose its one electron. That means the valency of this sodium atom is 1. At the same time, the Cl atom, it gains its one electron. That is why its electrovalency is 1. It is minus 1, but we cannot represent them with a negative sign. Electrovalency of the elements, it can always represented in a positive sign and not in a negative sign. Okay, next, electrovalency is clear. It is the number of electrons that an atom, it should gain or lose during the formation of ionic bond. During the formation of ionic bond, the metals and the non-metals, they lose or gain the electrons. Those electrons, the metal, they used to lose the electrons, and the non-metals, they used to gain the electrons. Those gained and lost electrons are represented in terms of electrovalency, and the resulting bond is also known as a ionic bond and electrovalent bond. Then, if we look into the electrovalencies of different elements in our periodic table, if we go through the group 1, group first elements of our periodic table, group first elements yavirutte, alkali metals irutte, that means S block elements, alkali metals, they are having configuration 281 means first shell 2 electrons, second shell 8 electrons. In the valence shell, they contains how many electrons? 1 electrons. That is why these group 1 elements, they are always ready to donate this 1 electron to get the stable electronic configuration. Stable electronic configuration of what? 2,8. That means in order to attain octet electronic configuration, this group 1 elements always ready to donate its 1 electron. That is why this valency of this group 1 elements is how much now? the valency of this group 1 elements is 1. For example, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, etc. These are all the elements present in the group 1. All are having one electron in their valence shell. That is why the group valency of group 1 is 1. That means, in order to attain the stable electronic configuration, this group 1 elements, they used to lose its one electron. The number of electrons that an atom can lose. Lose means here, in order to get the stability, these elements can lose its one electron. That is why the group valency of this group 1 is 1. Okay, next, group 2 elements. It is group 2. Group 2 elements means it is also belongs to S block. It is alkaline earth metals. They are having a configuration of 282. That means in their valence shell, they used to have how many electrons here? They will have 2 electrons here in the valence shell of alkaline earth metals. That means group 2 elements, they used to have how many electrons? 2 electrons they are having. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, etc. These are all the elements present in the second group of our periodic table. All are having 2 electrons in their valence shell. If they want to attain a stable electronic configuration, means they used to lose these 2 electrons. That is why their group valency is equal to 2. In order to gain a stable electronic configuration, group 2 elements, they used to lose these 2 electrons. That is why the group valency of a group 2 elements is 2. Then group 13 elements, they are having the configuration of 283. All these group 13 elements, they possess 3 electrons in their valence shell. Okay, what are those elements present in that? Aluminium, gallium, etc. These are the elements present in this group 13 with 3 electrons in their valence shell. If they wanted to attain a stable electronic configuration, means they used to lose these 3 electrons. That is why after losing these 3 electrons, they attain a stable electronic configuration. That is why the group valency or electrovalency of this group 13 elements is 3. Next we will move on to group 14 elements that belongs to a carbon family. That is, they are having electronic configuration of 284, carbon, silicon, germanium, etc. These are the elements present in the group 14, where they have the electronic configuration of 284, where the last shell, that means the valence shell of group 14 elements, which consists of how many electrons? Which consists of 4 electrons here. That is why the group valency of 14 elements is 4. But here it's an exception case, where in the group 14, these elements which do not undergo loss of electrons, but which involves the sharing of electrons, mutual sharing of electrons. As I already told in the last class, in this carbon atom, because of difficulties in losing the electrons, because of losing this 4 electrons, it need to share with the 4 electrons with the other 4 atoms, and it can exist electrovalency of 4. Okay, that is why the group 14 elements, in order to get its stable electronic configuration, instead of losing this 4 electrons, they used to undergo some mutual sharing. They used to involvement in a mutual sharing with the other atoms to get the remaining 4 electrons to get the stable electronic configuration. That is why the group valency of group 14 is equal to 4. Okay, next, for group 15 elements, they are having configuration of 285. It is 285. Look at the configuration here, 285 it is. Is it possible to lose its 5 electrons? Here, which is the possible condition? Whether This group 15 elements, they used to lose its 5 electron, or whether they used to gain 3 electrons. Which one is easy for them? In order to attain stable electronic configuration, they used to lose 5 electrons, or they used to gain 3 electrons. But here, to lose 5 electrons, excess amount of energy is utilized. In order to lose this 5 electrons, we need to apply more amount of energy. Instead, in order to accept those 3 electrons, if it absorbs 3 electrons, it can easily attain the stable electronic configuration. That is why, instead of losing this 5 electrons, these group of 15 elements, they used to gain 3 electrons. 3 electrons and again, we used to represent it by 3. It is minus 3 agabeku, but it is not represent, we should not represent electrovalency in a negative sign. That is why we just represent this group 15 elements, they used to accept 3 electrons. That is why we can represent it with, we can represent it with 3 electrons, or the electrovalency of a group of 15 is 3. Okay, next, group 16 elements, they used to have 2-8-6 configuration, that is oxygen family. Okay, next, this is nitrogen family, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, here oxygen, sulfur, selenium. Group 16 elements, they are having 2-8-6 configuration, where here group 16 elements, they have two possibilities. Either they used to lose its 6 electrons, or they used to gain 2 electrons. Which one is good? To lose its 6 electrons, they used to spend more amount of energy. That is why, in order to gain an electronic configuration of a stable electronic configuration, they are always ready to gain the electrons instead of losing the electrons. That is why it is easy to accept 2 electrons instead of losing this 6 electrons to get the stable electronic configuration. That is why group 16 elements, instead of losing this 6 electrons, they can easily accept 2 electrons. Acceptance of 2 electrons means we can represent it by 2 and not with minus 2. Group valency or electrovalency, which cannot be represented with the positive sign, we can always represent it with a positive sign. Okay, next, group 16 is over, then we will move on to the group 17 elements are nothing but halogens. These are having a 2-8-7 configuration. Halogens are those fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. These are the halogens which are having 7 electrons in their valence shell. Instead of losing the 7 electrons, they easily accept 1 electron to get their stability. That is why electrovalency of this group 17 elements is 1. Okay, it is minus 1, but we cannot represent it with a negative sign. Okay, it is group 17. If group 18, which is a noble gas elements, which consists of, they are having 0 valency. Okay, next, in between these two elements, some more groups are there, from group 2 elements to group 12 elements. Okay, from group 2 to group 3 to group 12 elements, we can call them as D block elements. These D block elements galige variable electrovalency irthade. They do not possess a particular electrovalency. Means the electrovalency of these elements, means the elements which comes in between these groups, 3 to 12 groups, means the D block elements which do not possess a particular electrovalency. Instead, they can represent multiple electrovalency. They can exhibit a different electrovalency. If you take an example of iron, iron can exhibit two valencies. It is either existed as plus two state also, and it can existed as a plus three state also. Okay, this example shows that this group elements, that means these d block elements, which shows different or multiple electro valencies. Okay, is it clear this concept of a ionic bond, which is also called as electrovalent bond? Why this is called electrovalent bond means which involves the loss or gain of electrons, which is represented in terms of a electrovalency. Electrovalency. So the next concept is a factors that affects ionic bond. Factors affecting the formation of ionic bond. What are the factors that affects the formation of ionic bond? In order to form the ionic bond, what are the favorable conditions, or we can say it as favorable conditions for the formation of ionic bonds. What are the favorable conditions required for the formation of ionic bond? Here, in order to form ionic bond, we need to have positively charged ion and a negatively charged ion is required. First, we go through the possible conditions or favorable conditions for the formation of a cation. Okay, first, for cations, favorable conditions for the formation of cation. The very first condition, large atomic radius. Okay, if a favorable condition for a cation, ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಆಟಮ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ದಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್. ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಆಲ್ಕಲಿ ಸೀರೀಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ, ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಷಿಯಂ, ರುಬಿಡಿಯಂ, ಸೀಸಿಯಂ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಲೆಸರ್ ಸೈಜ್ ದೆನ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, sodium has lesser size than potassium, followed by rubidium, followed by cesium. Okay, the atomic size is like this. If we consider the atomic size like this, here the atomic size is go on increasing now. With the increase in the atomic size, what happens here? The distance from the nucleus to electrons present in the outermost shell has increased. With the increase in the atomic size, the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron increases after that. What happens when we increase the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron? Distance increase adre en aagtade, the force of attraction between the electron and the nucleus decreases. With the increase in the atomic radius, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the outermost electron decreases. With the increase in the distance between the nucleus, consider this as a nucleus and this as an electron. With the increase in the distance, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron decreases. With the decrease in the force of attraction, what happens? We can easily remove this electron. After the removal of electron, the atom becomes cation. That is the favorable condition for the formation of cation. You just remember, with the increase in the atomic size, distance between the nucleus and the electron present in the outermost shell, that increases. With the increase in the distance, the force of attraction between the electron and the nucleus decreases. With the decrease in the force of attraction, we can easily remove this electron by providing a less amount of energy, less amount of ionization energy. Kadime energy kotru ee electron remove aagutade. After the removal of electrons, what happens? If atom it loses its electrons, means it becomes a cation. Okay, this is the first possible condition or favorable condition for the formation of a cation. Okay, if the size of the atom is large, then it can easily become cation. Okay, larger the size of cation are atoms with the atoms with large atomic radius, large atomic radius can easily become cation. Okay, now you understand the concept. Atoms with the large atomic radius can easily become cations. Why they easily become cation? With the increase in the atomic radius, force of attraction decreases, the removal of electron becomes easy. With the removal of electrons, they easily become cation. Okay, like that. Here, if you consider this case, which is the element which can easily become cation, means this is cesium is the element which easily become cation because it is having higher in size, the atomic radius of cesium is more, instead followed by rubidium, followed by potassium, followed by sodium, followed by lithium. Okay, here at the atomic size of cesium is more, that is why the force of attraction between the electron and the nucleus is less, that is why it can easily becomes a cation. Okay, next, what is the second possible condition or possible favorable condition for the formation of cation? The second condition is a ionization energy. Okay, what is meant by this word ionization energy? If we take an example of any element, you can take, it is filled with electrons, this is the nucleus, this is the first shell, and this will be the second shell which consists of electrons. If we want to remove this electron, if we want to remove any one of the electron from this outermost shell, we need to apply some amount of energy. Na ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನನ್ನು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಎನರ್ಜಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಗೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಔಟರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಶೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೇಷಿಯಸ್ ಆಟಮ್. ಒಂದು ಆಟಮಿಂದ ಔಟರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೆಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸನ್ನು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್, ವೆದರ್ ದ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಯಾವ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಲೆಸ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ಹೊಂದಿರ್ತವೋ, ದೇ ಕೆನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ದೆನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ದ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ದ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಇಂಟು ಆಟಮ್ ಇಂಟು ಕ್ಯಾಟಯನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ with the low ionization energy which can easily converts atoms into cations, those who atoms which possess low ionization energy, yava energy yava atoms gulu electron anna remove madlikke kadme energy anna tagoltavo, they easily converted into cations. Okay, if they take an example of sodium, magnesium, aluminium. Okay, here in this case ionization energy increases. In this case sodium has a less ionization energy, followed by magnesium, followed by aluminium. Okay, in this case, which is the atom which converts into cations more easily? Means sodium which converts into cation more easily than magnesium, followed by aluminium, because in this series aluminium has more ionization potential than magnesium, than sodium. That is why the removal of electron electron from this aluminium becomes more difficult than magnesium followed by sodium. That is why in this series sodium it will become cation more easily than magnesium and aluminium. Okay, the atoms, it concludes that the atoms which possess lower ionization energy, they can easily become cations than the atoms with the higher ionization energy. Okay, then the next condition, third condition for the favorable condition for the formation of cations is a shielding effect. Shielding effect, this concept you had already learned in the third chapter, that is periodic table concept. Shielding effect, what is meant by this word shielding effect? If we consider atomic structure of any element, that is here the inner shells are completely filled, inner shells are completely filled with their capacity, and the outer shells which contains one or two electrons. Here the electrons present in the inner shell, which protects the electrons present in the outer shell towards nuclear attraction. This process is called shielding effect. I repeat, the electrons present in the inner shell, which protects electrons present in the outer shell towards nuclear attraction. ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಶೀಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಶೆಲ್, ಯಾವ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಶೆಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತವೋ ಅವು ಔಟರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಶೆಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸನ್ನು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಕಡೆ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದನ್ನು ತಡಿತವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅ ಶೀಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. If it is strongly attracted towards the nucleus, shielding effect is less unquote, poor shielding effect unquote. Andre ee electron galu nuclear charge anna protect martta illa anta. And then this nuclear charge, it strongly holds this electron, strong agi hold martta ide antandre this removal of electrons becomes difficult. In order to remove this electron, we need to apply more amount of ionization energy, right? In order to remove the electron, we need to apply more amount of energy. Okay, yavaga poor shielding effect iddaga, in case of a strong shielding effect, strong shielding effect andre electrons of inner shell which protects the outer electrons from nuclear attraction, ee case iddaga, strong shielding effect iddaga, this electron is under less control of nucleus. The force of attraction between this nucleus and electron is less in case of strong shielding effect. In such cases, the formation of a cation becomes more pronounced. Why? Because there is a strong shielding effect. The force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron is less. The removal of electron becomes more easy. Removal of electron more easy aagta ide andre conversion into a cation becomes more easy. Okay, that is why stronger the shielding effect, stronger the shielding effect, formation of cation becomes more easy. Formation of cations becomes more easy. Suppose if the shielding effect is less ankoli, poor shielding effect idre ee inner shell alliro electrons outer shell anna protect madlilla antandre this electron nucleus under ge hogtade, strong force of attraction aagtade, avaga removal of electron difficult aagtade, formation of cation kuda difficult aagtade. Okay, what is the condition here? If the atoms which possess a stronger shielding effect means they can easily, the tendency towards converting into cations becomes more pronounced here. Okay, next, what is the fourth point? Cations with stable electronic configuration. Cation with stable electronic configuration. Okay, if you take an example of calcium and zinc, how many electrons are there in the valence shell of calcium? It is having 2 8 8 2 configuration. It is having 2 electrons in its valence shell as it belongs to alkaline earth metal. Okay, then what about zinc? It is having 2 8 8 10 2 configuration. It is having the atomic number of zinc is 30, where it is having 2 electrons in its valence shell. Calcium also having 2 electrons in its valence shell. Out of this calcium and zinc, which one is going to be converted into cation more easily? Yava element stable electronic configuration na hondirtado adu bega cation aagi convert aagtade. Then how can we conclude that which one is stable? Here also 288, here also 288 is there, but this stable electronic configuration and now octet configuration anta karitave, this is called octet electronic configuration. Instead, this electronic 2 8 8 10, this type of electronic configuration is called what? Pseudo electronic configuration. This is called what? Pseudo electronic configuration. Pseudo electronic configuration anta karitave. Okay, this electronic configuration is called octet, and this is called pseudo octet athwa pseudo electronic configuration anta karithiri. When we compare the stabilities of these two states, means in between octet and pseudo electronic configuration na compare madidre, octet electronic configuration is more stable. Okay, after losing this electron, here calcium which possesses octet role, means here shielding effect is more pronounced, strongly shielding effect is pronounced in case of calcium, but in case of zinc shielding effect is poor shielding effect is exhibited by zinc, strong shielding effect is exhibited by calcium. Here strong shielding effect na exhibit martta ide antandre, strong shielding effect, nuclear charge is protected, removal of electron becomes more easy. Okay, followed by this poor shielding effect antandre, electrons nucleus, protection of nuclear charge is less, electrons are moving towards the nucleus, they are under the strong force of attraction of the nucleus, such that the removal of electron from this pseudo electronic configuration becomes more difficult because of a poor shielding effect. In case of calcium, strong shielding effect, removal of electron becomes easy, such that formation of cations becomes easy. So in case of zinc, it is exhibits a poor shielding effect. Poor shielding effect means protection of nuclear charge is less, that is why the electron which comes near to the nucleus, means the force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron is more pronounced in case of what? In case of poor shielding effect, force of attraction is more, means removal of electron becomes difficult. Removal of electron becomes difficult means formation into cations is also becomes difficult. That is why in case of a calcium and zinc or any other element, if it possesses a octet configuration or strong shielding effect, which we can convert it into cations more easily rather than the elements which possess a pseudo electronic configuration. That is why in case of calcium and zinc, calcium Ca plus 2 is converted into cation more easily than Zn plus 2 because of a shielding effect. Okay, is it clear? Next, what are the favorable conditions for the formation of cation? For the formation of cation, the very first condition, it is large atomic radius. With the increase in the atomic radius, force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron decreases, followed by the removal of electrons becomes easy. With the removal of electron, then conversion into a cation becomes more easy. Then second point is low ionization energy. Those atoms which possess low ionization energy, ionization energy means energy required to remove the electron. Okay, if the electron is removed with the apply of a less amount of energy, means easily it will become cation. That is why lower the ionization energy of an electron, more easily it will become cation. And the third one is shielding effect. Atoms with more shielding effect. Atoms with a stronger shielding effect are easily become cations rather than atoms which possess poor shielding effect. The fourth one, it is cation with a stable electronic configuration. Yava atom gulu stable electronic configuration na hondirutte after losing the valence electrons. Okay, those can easily become cations rather than the atoms which consists of a pseudo electronic configuration. Okay, is it clear? Next, factors favorable for the formation of anion. Factors favorable for the formation of anion. For anion, it is okay. If we consider the atomic size of anion. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು, ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು, ದೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಆಗಿ ಈಸಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನಯಾನ್ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ಆನಯಾನ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ? ಬೈ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಆನಯಾನ್. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈ ಆಟಮಿನ ಸೈಜು ದೊಡ್ಡದಿರಬೇಕೋ ಚಿಕ್ಕದಿರಬೇಕೋ? ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಇಫ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಶೆಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೈಟ್. ಮೋರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಜ್. ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು which one is having the stronger force of attraction? Here, this is a smaller size atom which has a stronger tendency to accept the electrons because of a stronger force of attraction between the nucleus. This nucleus is ready to accept this electron. But here, the distance between the nucleus and the shell, outermost shell, is more. There is a larger difference is there. In order to accept the electrons, the force of attraction between the nucleus and this electron is less. That is why lower the atomic size of atoms, lower the atomic size of the atoms, atomic size of the atoms, lower the atomic size of the atoms, atomic size and atomic radius, both are same, atomic size, then formation of anion becomes more easy. Formation of anion becomes more easy. Lower the atomic size of the atoms. Atoms gala size eshtu kadame aagtado nucleus go outermost shell go force of attraction strong aagtade aga electrons anadu easyagi abstract maadkoltade. That is why in order to compare, if you take an example of fluorine, bromine and iodine molecule, out of these series, which atom is having smaller in size? Fluorine. Size of fluorine is smaller than chlorine, smaller than bromine, smaller than iodine. Okay, out of these four atoms or four elements, which one has greater tendency to form anion means fluorine, because of its smaller size. Because of its smaller size, what happens? With the smaller in size, nuclear force of attraction over the electron is more. That is why this nucleus easily attracts the one electron and easily converted into anion. Okay, now we conclude that lower the atomic size of the atoms, then they can easily become anions. Tendency to become anion is increases with the decrease in the atomic size. Atomic size ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಅದು ಆನಯನ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇವರಬಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನಯನ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಹೈಯರ್ electron gain enthalpy. The next concept is, or higher electron affinity you can take. Higher electron affinity antanadru tagoli, electron negativity antanadru tagoli. Okay, what is meant by this word electron affinity? This is an ability of an atom to attract the electrons towards itself. Higher electron affinity. Electron affinity means it is the ability of an atom to attract the electrons towards itself. Okay, adanna navu enuntivi electron affinity, attraction towards the electrons and the electron affinity. Okay, here electron affinity jaasti aadre formation of anion jaasti aagutada, or electron affinity kadame aadre formation of anion jaasti aagutada? If an electron affinity is more, electron affinity andre force of attraction or attraction towards the electrons, ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಆಟಮು ಆನಯನ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಫಿನಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆನಯಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನಯಾನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಫಿನಿಟಿ ಲೆಸ್ ಆದರೆ ಆನಯಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಕೂಡ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಫಿನಿಟಿ ಅಂದರೆ it is the attraction towards the electrons, nucleus which attracts the electrons, na, that is electron affinity. If the electron affinity is more, nucleus which attracts the more and more electrons means and it will become anion more easily. Electron affinity is more means it will become anion more easily. If the electron affinity is less, affinity means attraction, electron affinity is less means formation tendency to form anion is also less. Okay, this is the second condition. And what about third condition? Third condition, first we will discuss with these two concepts. First, atomic radius is small idre enagutade tendency to form anions becomes more easy. If the atomic radius is larger, distance between the nucleus and the electron decreases and tendency to form anions is decreases. In the second one, higher the electron affinity means high, if the affinity towards the electron is more means the force of attraction towards the electron is more means more easily it will become anion. And if the electron affinity means attraction towards the nucleus, electron nucleus attraction is more means more easily it will become anion. Okay, these are the favorable conditions for the formation of anion and cation. Okay, favorable conditions for the formation of anion and cation. Now iva gottaitu how do we prepare cation and how do we make anions anta. Okay, first we have prepared Na plus cation na prepare madkondvi, followed by preparation of NaCl minus takes place. In between these two, one bond can takes place here. And what is the nature of this bond? The nature of this bond is ionic bond or electrovalent bond anta karithivi. Okay, the nature of bond, what is the strength of this bond, whether this bond is weak or strong? This is the most strong bond. This is most strong bond because this is the electrostatic force of attraction which holds these oppositely charged ions together. That is why, because of its stronger electrostatic force, this bond becomes more stronger. Okay, illi cation ide anion ide ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಸಮ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್, ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ವೈಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಬಾಂಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ and that energy we call it as a lattice energy. Okay, the amount of energy released, the amount of energy released when one mole of compound is formed. One mole of ionic compound is formed from its gaseous cations and anions. Okay, it is the amount of energy released when one mole of ionic compound is formed from their gaseous cations and gaseous anions. This is called lattice energy. ಈ ಬಾಂಡ್ನ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಲ್ಯಾಟೈಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಕೂಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಟೈಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ? ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ gaseous cation and gaseous anion. Okay, here one doubt arises. After sodium, after losing one electron, it will become Na plus. It is solid state alirthade electron kalkodutte. After losing this one electron, it will become gaseous atom. Okay, then Cl atom, after gaining the one electron, it will become Cl minus. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಸಾಲಿಡ್, ಸಾರಿ ಇದು ಗೇಷಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ವೇರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಆಟಮು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಲೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನು ಇಟ್ ಅಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್. ಸಿ ಎಲ್ ಆಟಮು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಗೈನಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನು ಇಟ್ ಅಟೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್. ರೈಟ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ನ. ಎನ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ 2-8 ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್. Cl minus is also stable because it is having 2-8-8 configuration, but still they undergoes bonding, still they undergoes combination to form ionic compound. Yake combine aagbeku even though they are strong and stable? After losing the electron, this also attains stability, this also attains stability, but still there is a bond formation takes place between these two. What is the necessity of bond formation? The necessity is these two atoms exist in a gaseous state. These two ions, the state of these two ions is gaseous state, followed by after the formation of a compound, this molecule or this ionic compound should exist in a solid state. If we consider the stabilities of a gaseous state with a solid state which is more stable, followed by the two gaseous states. In order to attain that stability, these two gaseous atoms which undergoes combination and which results in the formation of which molecule it is, one mole of NaCl or one mole of any ionic compound it can take. Okay, in order to attain the stability. Okay, then if the strength of this Na plus and Cl minus and this ionic bond, if the strength of that ionic bond is more, then the amount of energy released during this reaction is also more. That amount of energy is nothing but what? Lattice energy. What is meant by lattice energy? The amount of energy released when one mole of ionic compound is formed from its gaseous atoms. If the bond strength is more pronounced, then lattice energy released is also more. Okay, next. Then, what are the properties of these ionic compounds? Properties of ionic compounds. What are the properties of these ionic compounds? The very first property, that is physical state. What is the physical state of ionic compound? Okay. Because of a stronger electrostatic force of attraction between the oppositely charged ions, the physical state of these ionic compounds is solids. They are solids. And the force of attraction between these solids is more because of a strongest electrostatic force of attraction. Okay. Usually the physical state of ionic compounds is a solid. They can exist as a solids. Why? Because of a stronger electrostatic force of attraction. Okay, second one, conductivity. conductivity. If we consider the conductivity of ionic compounds, they acts as a bad conductors of electricity, in their solid state. Okay, bad conductors of ionic compounds or bad conductors of electricity in their solid state. Why? Even though they contains ions, they acts as a bad conductors of electricity. Yaake? We know that they contains ions, but because of a strong force of attraction in case of a solids, how about the arrangement of ions in case of solids? In case of solids, the arrangement of ions are more tight and the movement of ions is not possible. Means those ions are strictly arranged and there is no possibility for those ions to conduct electricity, because there is no possibility for those electrons to move from their positions, because the positions of their ions is fixed in their solid state. That is why they do not conduct any electricity. That is why they are the bad conductors of electricity in their solid state. Suppose in their molten state, and in their aqueous state, okay, molten state means after the application of heat. Suppose if you can take any ionic compound na tagotri, you just apply some amount of heat. After the application of heat, what happens? There is a decrease in the strength of bond takes place, bond breakage takes place. After the application of heat, what takes place? If you take an NaCl as an example, NaCl ಗೆ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ನ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಹೀಟ್ ನ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಬ್ರೇಕೇಜ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಫ್ರೀ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್? ಇಫ್ ದ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಫ್ರೀ, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ಮಾಲ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಟ್ ದ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಕಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಮಾಲ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ದೇ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗುಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. Followed by in aqueous state. Aqueous state means here without the application of heat, simply we dilute the solution. Suppose from one container you just take out some ions outside another container and to this container add some amount of water, dilute madidre ankol, avaga en aagtade illinda tegedu illige aakiro ions gala nadivina bond en irthade, that going to be decreased. What is the work of water? Means aqueous state means if after the application of water na add madidmele, which decreases the strength of the bond na decrease madutte. Strength of the bond decrease aadmele enagutade, they become free ions which carries electricity. Okay, what is the work of aqueous state? Aqueous means water, aqua means water. After the addition of water, what it can do means which decreases the strength of the bond, followed by the release of ions takes place, such that those released ions which can conduct the electricity. So that in molten state and in aqueous state, ionic compounds acts as a very good conductors of electricity. They conduct electricity in molten state as well as in aqueous state. Okay, but they acts as a bad conductors of electricity in their solid state because of a stronger force of attraction between the ions. Ions are not free to move here, but in case of molten state and aqueous state, here the ions are very free to move. That is why they can easily conduct electricity. Okay, next, the third one is a melting and boiling point. So what are the melting points and boiling points of these ionic compounds? Whether they have less melting and boiling points or higher melting and boiling point, the melting and boiling point of ionic compounds are usually high. Why? Because these are the ionic compounds and the nature of bond or nature of a force between these two ions, these ions, is electrostatic. That electrostatic force of attraction is more stronger In case of ionic compounds, these ions are held up by electrostatic force of attraction, and because of a strong force of attraction, we need to apply more amount of energy to break the bonds in case of melting and boiling point. In the form of melting point agirbodu, boiling point agirbodu, the ionic compounds, they require excess amount of energy in the form of heat to break themselves into ions. That is why melting and boiling point ionic compounds possess higher melting and boiling points. These ionic compounds, because of a stronger electrostatic force of attraction, they possess higher melting and boiling point. Okay, next, these three points are clear. The physical state, they are solid in nature because of their electrostatic force of attraction. They can exist in solid state, followed by the conductivity. In their solid state, they act as a bad conductors. In their molten and aqueous state, they will become good conductors of electricity, followed by the melting and boiling point. They are held up by electrostatic force of attraction. More amount of heat is required for the breakage of bonds in the form of melting and boiling points. That is why these ionic compounds which possesses higher melting and boiling points. Right. Next. The next one, it is solubility. What is the solubility of ionic compounds when they are added into a solutions? Okay, these ionic compounds are easily soluble in polar solvents. Ionic compounds, being they contain ions, they are soluble in polar solvents. There is one rule is there in chemistry, that like dissolves like. That means ionic compounds, they easily dissociated under polar solvents, and non-ionic compounds, they easily dissociate under non-polar solvents. Here we have ionic compounds, that is why they are easily soluble under polar solvents. Soluble in polar solvents. Is it clear? Okay, next. The fifth one, it is isomerism. What is meant by this word isomerism? Isomerism means if the compounds having same molecular formula, but different structural formula. ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವೇನಂತೀವಿ, ಐಸೋಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಸಚ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ NaCl, ವಿಚ್ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್. ಆ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಶೇಪ್. In such cases, isomerism, same molecular formula, but they do not possess a structural formula. ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಶೇಪೇ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರ್ತದೆ? ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸು ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್. Carbon compounds are covalent in nature, but here we are talking about ionic compounds, those ionic species which do not have proper shapes because of their non-directional behavior. That is why they do not possess or they do not exhibit this isomerism concept, but they can exhibit one more concept, that is isomorphism. Ionic compounds, they do not exhibit isomerism, instead they can exhibit isomorphism. What is meant by this word isomorphism? Isomorphism means, if you consider some of the ionic compounds, magnesium oxide, if you consider potassium sulfide, followed by calcium chloride. Okay, these are all the ionic compounds in which both the atoms possess a same number of electrons. Both the atoms here, potassium, sulfur, both the atoms possess the same number of electrons. Here also calcium and chloride, both the atoms possess the same number of electrons. This property of ionic compounds is nothing but isomorphism. Okay, now we look into this concept. The first example, that is magnesium. What is the atomic number of magnesium? It is 12. Now, after losing these two electrons, it becomes how much? Mg plus 2 means it is having 10 electrons. Oxygen acquires, or oxygen accepts that 2 electrons now. Oxygen O minus 2. Atomic number of oxygen is 8. After gaining these 2 electrons, it becomes 10 electrons. Mg, atomic number of magnesium is 12. After losing this 2 electron, it is having 10 electrons. This property is nothing but isomorphism. Ionic compounds in which the atoms are in molecules, the atoms which possesses the same number of electrons is called isomorphism. Okay, next, in the second example, potassium, atomic number is 19, it is having positive charge, and sulfur, it is having a negative charge, yes, minus 2. Okay, after losing this one electron, potassium, after losing this one electron, it is becomes 18 electrons, it is having 18 electrons. Sulfur, atomic number of sulfur is 16, after gaining these two electrons, okay, here one potassium donates one electron, and another potassium donates another electron. That is why this sulfur carries minus 2 charge. Okay, yes, minus 2, that means it is having 18 electrons. At the last example, that is calcium chloride, in this example, calcium being atomic number 20, after losing 2 electrons, it is having 18 electrons with it, and this chlorine, after gaining 1 electron, atomic number of chlorine is 17. After gaining 1 electron, it becomes 18. This property of ionic compounds is nothing but isomorphism. Okay, these are the properties of ionic compound. In today's class, we were discussed regarding the concepts of electrovalency. Electrovalencies of different elements present in our periodic table, followed by the properties of ionic compounds. We discussed regarding the concept of lattice energy. Okay, next. In the next class, we are going to discuss regarding the concept of lattice energy, right? Thank you.